Conitz, and your ear told you there was also a tenor saxophonist. It was Warren Marsh. And out of the old Basie book, Topsy. Always an interesting thing to listen to. Let's listen to Louis Armstrong. Louis and I Got a Right to Sing the Blues. Louis Armstrong, and one of the great ones by Louis. Let's see, we haven't played Tatum yet, have we? It'd be a good idea to. I picked out a record called California Melodies. It was a radio show that happened about every week, and Art Tatum was one of the regular feature artists, and he'd almost always select two compositions to play as part of the medley. And thus it's called California Melodies. California Medleys? Melodies. Take your choice. Here's the melody of Begin to Begin and Caravan. Art Tatum from 1940.
Imagination in music? You've heard it. Hear it raised to the zenith as Art Tatum meets a piano. Art Tatum started meeting pianos when very young. Strange. In Toledo. Since then, he's been meeting pianos all over the world. Now we come to his startling interpretation of Begin the Begin. Ever seen a desert? There are all kinds of deserts: Sahara, Peruvian, South African, Californian. California Melodies places Art Tatum at the piano again, and tonal color flashes from the keyboard as he pictures in music a desert, any desert, playing Caravan.
Radio program called California's Melodies, not plural, California's, California Melodies, featured David Rose and his orchestra and an announcer introducing Art Tatum. And there are two selections by Tatum in every program with 24 programs listed. So there's, and almost all of it is new Tatum, hasn't been issued before. Here's Sonny Stitt with a group that includes Joe Newman, trumpet, Duke Jordan, piano, Sam Jones, bass, and Roy Brooks, the drummer. And Sonny Stitt with his saxophone. I don't know whether it's tenor or alto here. We'll have to find out. This is Walkin'.
Thank you.
Five Spot After Dark, a Benny Golson composition. He wrote so many of those nice, easy swinging, subtle melodies, of which that was one. And by the way, it was called Five Spot After Dark. Here's a Fats Navarro thing that I've always liked, therefore I've played it a lot. With Charlie Rouse, tenor saxophone, Tad Dameron, the pianist, Nelson Boyd, the bassist, and Art Blakey, the drummer, recorded in 1947, December 5th of 1947. This is Nostalgia. And that was Fats Navarro with Nostalgia. Charlie Rouse was the tenor saxophonist. Actually, it was the Tad Dameron band from one of the New York clubs. How long has it been since we played something by Cal Jader? Long time. Carl T. Jader, as he was known to that disc jockey I used to work with who mispronounced so many of the names. Carl T. Jader. Let's listen to Cal and Lonnie Hewitt, his pianist, Victor Venegas, and Eddie Coleman were the bassists on the session. Willie Bobo and Mongo Santa Maria were here to give it that Latin flavor. This is Day In, as announcers, or not announcers, vocalists, who don't pay much attention to enunciation. Day in, day out. Jader, and day in, day out. That's it for this hour. couple of minutes out for some important message, and that Terry got together back in the late 1950s and played a few gigs on the West Coast, places like the Summit, and he was, you know, big bands were dying all over the place, and Terry picked a poor time to try and start a big band, but he made a little bit of an impression with it, with disc jockeys who liked better type music. He was happy with them. And I know I used to play it a lot, and the fellas here at the station used to play Terry Gibbs a lot. And then it kind of died off, and we haven't heard much from him, so I decided we'd do a whole program of Terry and his big band. This is from an album called Explosion. And let's kick it off with an Al Cohn arrangement of Moon Glow. Terry Gibbs and the big band, and that was Moon Glow, Al Cohn, arrangement of Moon Glow. Charlie Kennedy was the alto soloist, and Conti Candoli was the trumpet soloist. By the way, the personnel of this band, such a wonderful personnel, so many great players from the West Coast. Al Porcino was playing most of the lead trumpet. Conti Candoli and Stu Williamson were playing the jazz trumpets, most of it going to Conti. Ray Tiscari and Johnny Audino were splitting the lead book. Johnny Audino, who, one of those old-time trumpet players that can read around corners and give you a big fat sound and play ballads and whatever. He was also a member, a happy member, of the Doc Severinsen Tonight Show band. Elsewhere, we mentioned Conti Candoli and Stu Williamson. And Tiscari and Audino, they were the trumpets. The trombones were Bob Edmondson, Bob Pring, Frank Rossellino, and Tommy Shepard alternated on some of the sides instead of Rossellino. Joe Maney was the lead alto, first time he'd ever played lead alto. Terry thought he'd make a good lead alto man, and Terry was right. The hot alto solos are Joe Maney, and the other alto soloist, more Charlie Parker in line, was Charlie Kennedy. Now, let's see, who did we forget? Oh, we forgot the rhythm section. What a rhythm section. Lou Neavy was the pianist, Buddy Clark was the bassist, and Mel Lewis was the drummer. Mel Lewis was another one of those swinging drummers who just had more work than he could handle working in the studios. He was on the West Coast for most of these sides, but he left and went to New York. And I remember a quote from Zoot Sims, who said, the West Coast, after Brookmeyer left and went to New York, that he was going to do the same because the heart went out of the West Coast players. Here is the Terry Gibbs Band with Tico Tico. It didn't sound like a very big crowd, but it sounded like an enthusiastic crowd. Terry said that in order to keep that big band together, his regular working group was a quartet with Terry Pollard, who was one of the few female musicians who worked with the big boys. Terry said that he was charging the Summit the price for the quartet, but he was giving them a big band. That's because the guys wanted to play. They loved the big band sound, and they wanted to play. Here's one that every big band has played one time or another. Probably some of them are playing them right now. This is a Manny Album arrangement of the Moton Swing. And that was the Moton Swing, Manny Album arrangement of the Moton Swing. And it's one of those things that all of the big bands have played at one time or another. Next up, I don't have an arranger given on any credit on this one, but Sweet Georgia Brown. Oh, really? Look at the record, yes. Manny Album has the arrangement of Sweet Georgia Brown. And let's listen now to the Terry Gibbs Big Band, which we're featuring this hour. And the personnel that we gave you at the start of the program is still pretty much, although these records were